So the monsoon is clearly important from a thematic standpoint, as well as directly from an equity market perspective. Monsoon season is very important to the Indian economy because agriculture is about 15% of GDP, but more importantly, about 65% of India's population is rural and is either directly or indirectly dependent upon agriculture. And 50% also of the land is unirrigated, so it relies upon Mother Nature as opposed to any other constructed man-made facilitators for agriculture. And about half of the rain in the year comes during this concentrated period of June to September. Average rainfall, within some variation of the norm, is the desired amount. In 2015 and 16, we had some very poor years, and so this year we're looking for growing about 3.5%, which would result in about a 0.5% contribution to overall growth this year. So recognizing that if agriculture is contributing the 0.5% of GDP, it's actually much more important than that to about 280 million, close to 300 million farmers, and then all their sort of the direct chain that emanates from that in the rural economy. And this, by the way, is being amplified because of the current political cycle. So we have general elections coming up next year in 2019, and there is likely to be an incremental bias towards spending more on the rural economy, on proper infrastructure spending or other necessary investments. But when you combine those two, a good monsoon with the investment that's coming because of the political cycle, it suggests that there's a very good recovery story for the likes of not only consumer staples, but consumer durables, two-wheelers, etc. So it's very clear from a structural macroeconomic perspective that there are key ingredients for growth. But of course, life is never quite as simple as that, and Mother Nature can intrude upon this. And India is probably one of the foremost examples where the capriciousness of the weather cycle can detract from the structural growth potential that we're seeing. And so we need to be, I think, humble and respectful of what nature can do in terms of either amplifying or derailing the underlying structural growth prospects that one can expect.